So, what was covered in the last class? Do you remember, students? It's been a long gap in between. Anyone? This one, let me check in the drive. Now, this is the last class that I took on 31 August. Yeah. Okay. So we had started. We had started. The fabrication part in the last class, I think. Okay, fine. Okay, so we had seen these various techniques, okay, that are useful in fabrication of these ICs. Okay, so like how the single crystal is growth, okay, how the ingot is formed, by using a seed of silicon. Okay, this is the ingot and these are the circular wafers of silicon, okay, which are used for fabricating ICs on it. Okay, then we had seen this oxidation process to form the oxide, silicon dioxide, then photolithography, then patterning, how the patterning is done by using the photoresist layer and photo mask. Okay, this thing we had seen in the previous class, and we know that the photo mask contains some transparent areas and some opaque areas, and the light passes through those transparent areas and fall on the top of this photoresist and changes its property. Okay, depending on the type of photoresist, the light which interacts with some portion of photoresist, that portion becomes hard or soft. Okay, and then later on it can be etched out by using a proper chemical solvent. Then etching process we saw. Okay, and then there are some issues with the etching process, like these undercuts occur in some methods, and this may be tolerable for some designs, some design specifications, but some design specifications may be very strict about this undercut. So for those things we go with this anisotropic etching. Okay, then we saw the diffusion process. It's basically used for forming a n-type or p-type region in different type of substrate material. Okay, then ion implantation is again the same thing, not the same thing, it's a similar thing that is again used for creating different diffusion regions. Okay, then for deposition, chemical vapor deposition, in order to deposit some extra layer over another layer, Then metallization, basically when we want to deposit a metal layer that can be used as an interconnect or wire, okay, for those things metallization was used, right? Okay, so these different methods will be used throughout the fabrication of these ICs. Okay, these methods will be used repeatedly. Okay, so that's why I told them, I introduced to you them in the very beginning. Okay, so next we will start with the fabrication process. Okay, what are the actual steps in while fabricating, while going for fabrication? Okay, so look at here, we generally start with a foundation. Okay, we want to manufacture some kind of circuit, or suppose we want to manufacture an IC. Okay, so what does that contain? That IC will contain some sort of structure, some sort of circuits, connections. Okay, and obviously an IC will contain a large number of components on it, right? So basically it's an interconnection of a different or large number of components. So there would be a large number of MOSFETs sitting there on the top of the substrate, and they will be interconnected in a proper fashion to get a particular job done. Okay, so all those things are manufactured over our wafer, of silicon wafer, we know that thing. Okay, and this is the side view of those methods, those things. Okay, so from the side, if you look, the silicon substrate, suppose it looks like this. Okay, let us start with the silicon substrate. Okay, and here the aim is to achieve this one here in this slide. Let's say we will start from this figure A, and aim here is to go at figure G. Okay, and to have this kind of structure, okay, on the top of the silicon substrate, okay, where this is the silicon dioxide layer, okay. So how to obtain this structure on the top of the silicon substrate? Although it looks simple here, okay, but it involves various steps here. Okay, since all these things are happening at the nanometer scale, nanometer, you understand, 10 to the power minus 9 meter, at that very small size. Okay, so actually it is not that simple, it's very sophisticated. Okay, so let us see what are the steps that are that will be used here to get this structure from this structure. Okay, so we start with the silicon substrate, right? And first we deposit a layer of silicon dioxide, which is an oxide layer, okay, on the top of this silicon substrate by using oxidation process, maybe wet or dry oxidation process. Okay, those processes we have already covered. Okay, so we use one of those oxidation processes to deposit a layer of oxide on the top of this silicon substrate. Okay, this is done. Now after this, okay, we deposit a layer of photoresist. We deposit a layer of photoresist material on the top of this silicon dioxide layer. Okay, and we know that the photoresist material is sensitive to light. Its characteristic is sensitive to light. Okay, so next what we will do, by using a suitable mask, okay, this is the mask. And this mask actually contains the geometrical shapes and patterns which would be implanted on the top of the silicon substrate. Okay, so what it will have certain transparent regions and certain opaque regions. Okay, so these regions are opaque from here to here. and in the middle this region is transparent. Again here this is opaque. Okay, so mask contains some transparent and some opaque regions, and from the top UV light, the ultraviolet lights are bombarded, okay, are made to pass through this glass mask. Okay, so the light will pass only through the transparent areas, okay, and will pass through it and will hit on the top of this photoresist material. Okay, so in this region, and the light will not pass here in this region because these regions are opaque. Okay, so only this region of photoresist material will get exposed with light, and since this photoresist material is a light sensitive material, so the characteristic of this region which got in touch with the UV light will change. Okay, so now depending, we had seen there are two types of photoresist materials, positive photoresist material and negative photoresist material. Okay, so the property will change only for this region. Okay, let's say if it's a positive photoresist material, okay, then this region will become soft. Okay, the region which got exposed with UV light will become soft, and the other region which did not come in touch with UV light, they will remain hard. Okay, now what to do next is etching out of that soft region which became soft due to UV light exposure. Okay, and this etching of that portion of this photoresist material is done with the help of some suitable chemical etching solvents. Okay, for example, in this case, HF acid or hydrofluoric acid can be used for etching out this photoresist material. So that what happens, this region which became soft due to the exposure with UV light, this will get etched out. And the other area which remained hard, they will remain intact as it is. Okay, so we will get this structure. A window will open on the top of this silicon dioxide layer, and we can see this, the top of silicon dioxide layer. Okay, we can see through this window. Okay, now since this silicon dioxide layer is visible through this window, we can etch out this silicon dioxide layer with the help of another suitable chemical etching solvent. Okay, so that same thing is done here. Okay, now with the use of another suitable chemical etching solvent, this portion of silicon dioxide layer is again etched out, and these portions will remain intact. Why? Because they are covered with the photoresist material. Okay, so this portion of silicon dioxide layer will remain as it is, and the middle portion which was being exposed, okay, from the top, they will get etched out. Okay, so we wanted this window, right? We wanted this window only, but this photoresist material which is still sitting on the top of the silicon dioxide layer is not desired. So what we will do next, we will again remove this hardened photoresist material with the help of again some suitable solvents, so that this silicon dioxide layer is visible. Okay, and then we will obtain this structure. Okay, so look at here. So to obtain a simple pattern on the top of this silicon substrate, how many techniques are used in between? So from here to here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, at least 6 steps were there, and these are major steps. I have shown you only important steps. I have not shown you the detailed steps that every small and every small detailed step I have not shown. I have shown only the important major steps. Okay, so to obtain a simple structure, it has to go through some kind of methods or steps for this processing to be done so that we can obtain a particular pattern on the top of the silicon substrate. Okay, right. And again, keep in mind that this pattern started when we introduced this mask. The mask contained the geometrical shapes. Okay, and at this stage, which shape would be transferred on silicon substrate top? At this stage, it gets established. It gets started. Okay. So this is the that was the side view of the silicon substrate. Now this is a three-dimensional view of silicon substrate. So we started with this, okay, and we ended at this. So from side view it was looking like this, but when you look from the top it will look like this. It has got certain width, okay, it has got a certain width, right? And look at this. This window is open right through this, and throughout this complete width this window is open. Okay, so it's do not think that it is a two-dimensional processing. It's actually happening on the three-dimensional level. Okay, so this is the three-dimensional view of the simple processing that we saw in the previous slide. Okay, now by observing that steps for making a simple pattern, okay, now let us see what are the steps involved in the fabrication of one NMOS transistor. Okay, one NMOS transistor. NMOS transistor. NMOSFET is for N-type MOSFET or N-MOSFET. NMOSFET. Okay, just a minute. ये मानस सर, विजय के रूम में एक एप्लीकेशन होगा साइन करने के लिए, तो जाके एक बार साइन कर दीजिए, ये इंटरनेट का लैंड पोर्ट लगाने के लिए। उसके विजय के यहाँ होगा, थोड़ा जाके एक बार देख लीजिए। हम लोगों ने साइन कर दिया है। NMOS is basically a short for N MOSFET, right? And what is a MOSFET? You know that MOSFET is metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. Okay, it's a kind of transistor which is used for designing the ICs, basically. Okay, and in present day time, N MOSFET are the devices which are the widely used devices, right, for the designing of the IC circuits. Okay, although BJTs are also used, but only for a certain kind of applications. Most of the time you will see that the circuits are based out of the circuits are made up out of MOSFETs. Okay, so this becomes like I have read in some book that more than 95% of the whole world semiconductor circuit market is being captured by this device, this single device, MOSFET. Okay, be it NMOS or PMOS, basically it's a MOSFET. Okay, so in that sense, it becomes very important to study about this MOSFET structure in detail. Okay, so we should be completely aware about the operation of this device, this single device. So again, we will start with the same blank silicon substrate like this, shown in figure A. And our aim is to, look here, the aim is to obtain this structure, this MOSFET. So this is an MOS structure. side view. Okay, look at here. This is the silicon substrate, right? And NMOS means it's a N-channel MOSFET. The channel present is of N-type. Okay, and the channel is present between how many terminals? Between two terminals. And what are the names of those two terminals? Okay, the names are source and drain, right? So look at here. This is N plus region. This is N plus region, okay, which can act as a source or drain. This is another N plus region, which can also act as a source or drain. Okay, so and the contacts are taken out with the help of some metallic deposition here. So let's say we can define this as a source terminal. We can say that this is the drain terminal, and they are interchanged. We can use this one as drain and this one as source without any change in the operation of this device. The terminals are interchangeable in nature. The structure is symmetrical, completely symmetrical in nature. Okay, so this is the source terminal. This is the source region N plus. This is the drain region N plus. Okay, and in between source and drain, the channel would exist connecting the source and drain. Okay, if we apply a proper gate voltage at the gate terminal, and gate is present in between the source and drain. So this is the gate terminal. Okay, and when we apply a suitable voltage at the gate terminal, a channel consisting of N-type charge carriers, or basically free electrons, would get formed here and will connect this source and this drain. Okay, so basically this is the active area for NMOS structure. Okay, and obviously it needs some foundation, some structure on that it can be built upon, and that structure, that strength is being provided by this silicon substrate material. Okay, so we want to obtain this structure starting from the blank silicon in figure A. So this is the aim here. This is the aim here. So let us see what are the steps involved here in getting this NMOS structure. Okay. So let's start with the same silicon substrate here. Okay. And first of all, what is done is silicon dioxide layer is deposited on the top of the silicon substrate, again by using oxidation processes. Okay. So this is the silicon dioxide layer that is deposited on the top of silicon substrate, right? And students, if you have any doubt, you can ask at any time. Okay. Right. I hope you are listening, students.
Yes, sir.
Yamuna is present.
Yes, sir.
Is listening. Okay. So we will start with the deposition of silicon dioxide layer on the top of this silicon substrate, right? And we will pattern this silicon dioxide layer so that we get this window. We get this window on the top of the silicon dioxide layer. Now I have shown here just one step from here to here. Look at this. But in the previous slide, we saw that just this patterning requires around 4 or 5 different steps. Okay. So I assume that you are aware of those previous slide steps. You remember those steps. And you think that, okay, in obtaining this patterning from this thing, it involves those previous 4 or 5 steps. 4 or 5 techniques. Okay. So we pattern the silicon dioxide layer on the top and we get this pattern structure, right? Now, what is the next step? The next step is to deposit a thin oxide layer on the top surface completely. So this will cover the thick oxide layer as well as the window that got opened due to this patterning. Okay, so it will basically cover the top layer, the top surface, okay, completely, a thin layer of oxide. Okay, now, and this is basically a thin oxide layer which is of higher quality as compared to this thick oxide layer. Okay, because this will ultimately will form a part of gate, because if you see matter, MOSFET is called as MOSFET. So this metal O for oxide, S for semiconductor. So there is a MOS structure or MOS phenomena that is operating at the gate terminal. Okay, so we will see that at the gate terminal, at the gate region, we are having this MOS structure. Look at here. This one is the metal layer. Okay, or conducting. Basically, it is called metal, but nowadays they are using polysilicon more. Okay, a highly doped polysilicon layer which actually conducts. Okay, and this one is the oxide layer. Oxide layer, and when a channel is formed here, when a channel is formed connecting source and drain, that also is like a conducting layer, conducting channel. Okay, so what happens here is that we have two conducting channels, two conducting regions, and in between these two conducting regions we have one silicon dioxide layer, okay, or one insulator layer. So this forms a MOS capacitance, a parallel plate capacitance. So this shows a parallel plate capacitance effect here, and it is this effect which is responsible for the formation of this conducting channel, okay, and the amount of current that flows between source and drain. Okay, and that is why this name is very important, MOS, metal oxide semiconductor. Okay, so we had deposit a thin oxide layer on the top of silicon dioxide, okay, on the top of this thick oxide, as well as covering this window over silicon substrate, right? And then we cover again the whole surface with a layer of polysilicon, with a layer of polysilicon. Okay, so what is polysilicon? It's basically a type of silicon, okay, which contains various types of silicon crystals inside it. Okay, so that's why it's called silicon material. So internal structure is such that it contains various types of various crystals of silicon, okay, and it is basically very highly doped polysilicon that actually conducts. Because of the doping, the resistivity of this polysilicon gets reduced. Okay, otherwise, an undoped polysilicon layer, an undoped polysilicon material is having very high resistivity, very high resistance. So in order to use that thing, we need to dope this material so that the conductivity rise, the conductivity increases. Okay, okay, now after depositing this polysilicon on the top of this surface, okay, we pattern this again. How would we pattern this again? We will cover it with the photoresist material. We will use some set of mask, okay, and then some regions will become soft, some regions will become hard, and with the help of some proper chemical solvents, some soft regions will be etched out, right? So that previous slide steps will be followed. Okay, and we will be left with this structure. Only this portion of polysilicon is left here, is present here, and from the rest of the portions, this polysilicon is etched out. Okay. Again, by using that those same patterning processes, by using that those same patterning methods, okay, we modify it a little bit and we make these two windows. Okay, this one and this one, so that this surface, okay, this surface, this top surface of the silicon substrate here, here and here are visible from the top. Okay, now next, next what we do is, okay, so we were at this step. Next, just a minute, a call is coming.
Hello. Hello. Train. अच्छा चलो देखते हैं, लेकिन अभी मेरा क्लास चल रहा है तो रुको बता दें 10 मिनट में, ठीक है?
ओके ओके, सो वी डिपॉजिट एन इंसुलेटिंग ऑक्साइड लेयर अगेन ऑन द टॉप ऑफ दिस whole surface like this, so that it covers every portion of this top area. Okay, and we again pattern it so that this, again, this window is visible. Okay, and also here in this figure number H, when this window was made open for the first time, so what was done here is these two regions for N plus were created. So these two N plus diffusion regions were created here by using the techniques such as diffusion or ion implantation. Okay, we had seen these methods. Okay. So these windows were open so that these N plus regions can be created here. Okay. And then it was covered with an insulating oxide layer and it was patterned so that these two windows are opened up on the top of this these two N plus regions. Okay, and this whole surface is then covered with a layer of metal, let's say aluminium. Okay, and we do not want aluminium to be present everywhere. Okay, we want aluminium or the metal to be present only at certain specific locations, okay, or at certain contacts. So again, it needs those patterning methods. Okay, so after proper patterning, the metal layer from these regions are removed, and from here, from the middle portion, it is removed. Okay, and this black layer, okay, this one and this one are the metal layers that are sitting here on the top of this silicon substrate, right? Okay, so look at here, as I have already shown you, already told you that this is the one region of the MOSFET and this is another region of MOSFET. Okay, we may take take it as a source or drain, anything. Let's take it as source, okay? And let's say that this is a drain contact. And since this is a metal layer, this is in direct contact with this drain N plus region, okay? And here, this is a substrate, a silicon substrate. Basically, when we form a N MOSFET, right? We generally fabricate it on the top of P-type silicon substrate material. Okay. And the PMOS devices would be formed on N-type silicon substrate. Okay, so this is basically a P-type silicon substrate material. On the top of it, we are seeing this NMOS device. So this is the source region, this is the drain region, and this is the gate terminal. Okay, so this is oxide and this is polysilicon, and here the contact should be taken out from the polysilicon layer, and it will act as the gate terminal of this NMOS device. Okay, and this is the body. Okay, so we can either directly take, just for the illustration purpose, I show here that with the help of some metallic contact, okay, we can take out as the fourth terminal called as body or substrate. Okay, although we will see later on that another diffusion region is created on the side of these devices to get a contact with the body or substrate. Okay, we will see that thing, right? So these are the major steps that are followed that can be used for fabricating a NMOS device. Okay, similarly, we can use the same similar steps to get a PMOS device, PMOSFET. So what will be the changes? The changes will be in a complementary fashion, in the sense that we will start with N-type silicon substrate material, okay? And we would like to create P-plus diffusion regions, okay? So that we can have P-type channel created between source and drain, okay? So this will get inverted to P-type, P-plus, and this will be N-type substrate material, and it will behave like a PMOS device. So if we understand one kind of device, we can easily switch to the other kind of device. Okay, there is no issue with that. Okay, so these are the major steps, although I have not shown all the detailed steps that can be used for fabricating an MOSFET device, right? Now tell me, till here, any doubts, anything that you have or that you want to discuss? Because it's been some time gap since the last class, so I will not cover much here. I will just stop here for today's class, and we'll leave you with tips so that you can revise these things before we resume in the next class, and we will see the fabrication of CMOS inverter. Okay, that contains one NMOS and one PMOS, two devices. But here, just for a single device, for a single NMOSFET transistor, okay, what are the major steps that should be followed to fabricate it that we have seen today? So tell me, if there is any doubt, any query based on this, we can discuss.
Sir, what is the need of adding extra layer of polysilicon?
Polysilicon layer, where? Here,
and mostly
this one.
Yeah, in here we only added the thin oxide layer, but we added extra polysilicon layer.
Where in this one or in the next slide? This one, this layer.
In on the picture, they added there and what is it?
We have added polysilicon only one time, no? Look at this. This is the polysilicon material. This one is the polysilicon material that is deposited here. Okay. And it was patterned so that only this portion of polysilicon is remaining here. And from all these other areas, other portions, the polysilicon is etched away. Yeah. So this polysilicon region is present here, just this much. Then here, again, this polysilicon is present here. This is present here, in between. Look at here. This is here, in between. And this is here, in between. And this is here, again. So we have added polysilicon just for one time. Okay. We have not added it twice. Okay. We have, I think they have added oxide two times. Insulating oxide two times. Okay. Because if you look here, okay, here the channel will form, right? Okay, and on the top of it, we have this, this one.
Oxide.
The first oxide layer, first layer. Okay, and above oxide layer, we have this, which one? Polysilicon. Okay, and above this polysilicon, there's one more layer, which is the oxide layer. Okay, so when we take out the contact, we should be careful that we take out the contact from the oxide, not from the oxide, from the polysilicon. So we should reach the polysilicon level and take out the contact with the help of this metal, aluminium. From this second layer, not from this top layer, because the top layer is oxide. Okay. So we should reach out to this polysilicon layer to take out the contact properly. That will act as your gate terminal. Yeah. Okay. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Any other questions? Can you tell me that why this oxide layer is deposited once more? So this is the channel here that will form. Obviously, this is oxide. This is oxide, okay, and this is polysilicon, which is conducting in nature. Okay, so if they have not deposited this another oxide layer, then this metal line, which is conducting in nature, might have came in contact with this polysilicon, which is also conducting in nature. So if both of these would touch each other, it will impact the functioning of this NMOS transistor. And since we know that we apply a separate voltage at drain and at gate and at source, so if they touch each other, then it will be of no use. Okay, so might be to separate, to have a non-conducting layer between this polysilicon and this metal, this extra insulating oxide layer is deposited on the top of it so that they do not get shorted to each other. Yeah. Okay, any other questions? क्वेरी। Okay, if there is no doubt here, then we can go for the attendance. Give your attendance in the chat box. Write your roll number and name and post it in the chat box for your attendance. Okay. So type your roll number and